So I'm not sure if I'm going to actually make this into a video blog. I probably will, because, I don't know, it's kind of my video diary anyways. But, it's 11:11, make a wish. It's 11:11 at night over here. And I was about to go to sleep. I have a lot on my mind. I was reading. And just like a whole bunch of stuff flooding in my brain. So I don't feel like journaling right now because my wrists hurt and my shoulders hurt, and it's just not a good combination. So I thought it would be a better idea to do one of these and just sort of say everything that's on my mind, and anyone's interested, they'll watch. If not, whatever. So yesterday, I know I made a video blog yesterday, but yesterday I was really, really depressed, and I spent like 6 or 7 hours up in my room just like going over Skype messages and MDJ messages. MDJ is a online support group. I met my best friend, one of my two best friends in the entire world, one of my three best friends, actually, but, one of my two online-ish, I guess, I don't know, one of my two best friends that don't live here, that's where I met her, and she's the one that I've been really, really, really upset over. Nothing that has gone on has been caused by her, but I'm not gonna lie that it's been more or less affected by her, not by her but like what's been going on with us the past year. Just a lot of it has gone down. So I was really depressed, and I was feeling really reminiscent, which is not a good combination for me. I don't know if it's like that for anyone else, but when I feel really reminiscent and I'm really depressed, I tend to go through everything that I have, pictures, texts, posts, messages, whatever, and I just like read them and cry for like, so that's what I did for like 6 hours. And I tweeted something, I tweeted something along the lines of, and Twitter's being a real asshole right now, crap. I tweeted something along the lines of, like, I wish it was early 2011 again, because where I had my best friend and I didn't have this eating disorder. So yeah, I said, can I go back to early 2011 when I still had my best friend and I didn't have this eating disorder? What happened? And then I put her Twitter handle, and then I said, I miss you. And then I said, if I wasn't sick, would things be different? So I guess she had gone on Twitter after she got home from school. And then she tweeted me at like 11 o'clock at night. And we talked really quickly. And before I knew it, she was calling me. I was in the bathroom. So I came out and I messaged her and I said, sorry, I was in the bathroom, you know, I missed your call. And she said, call me back if you want to, if you don't, I understand. So obviously I did, because it was really, I mean, my every day I think of her, every day I worry about her, every day I wonder what could have gone differently, So anyways, we talked, and it was a good conversation, it was interesting, but, I don't know, it's just hard because I want to just, like, throw myself into the relationship. I just want to, like, give her a great big hug and be like, I missed you, but there's this huge chunk of me that's like, hold everything, like, I don't want to get into this again because I don't want my heart to be broken again. So, I don't know, I'm at like the standstill. And then I told my dad that I had talked to her last night, and he didn't really have a reaction. And then, my brother brought it up in front of my mom. I wasn't going to tell my mom because she really does not like her. Partially, well, she never really, she didn't dislike her, but I don't know. She just didn't fancy her as my friend. But when we split up, as like when we stopped being friends, she saw what it did to me, and so my mom was not, she wasn't very happy. I don't know, of course my brother had to be a big mouth, and then my sister had to go and try and fix it, and it just made it 10 times worse. I really wasn't going to get into it because I started for business and I didn't want to hear the lecture and I didn't want to hear about all the things that had happened, and I just didn't want to hear. So I didn't say anything, and now she's like, I'm going for a procedure again tomorrow for my back, which I'm also kind of stressing out about. So she's like, but we're going to be in the car for a good hour and a half, so we'll talk about it then, which I'm not looking forward to. So I get to do that tomorrow. Yay. And then last night, she had given me, Amber had given me a, homework assignment, I guess, we picked 3 things that I like about myself, or that are good about myself physically, and she wanted me to stand in front of a mirror and say, you know, I like this, I like this, and I like this. So 3 things were my skin, because apparently I have nice skin. I don't like it, but that's just because I don't like any part of me. She said that my legs were really skinny and long, which I don't see. I see the long part, I just don't see the skinny part. And then I said that I like my hair, which is like the, I like my hair and my eyes, and that's the only things that I like. I could go into long, long discussions about the things that I don't like. My nose, my face, my mouth, my birthmarks, my fingers, my hands. I'm just going to stop there because I can just keep going. So I was having a really good day because I was very happy still. And then, I was dancing, and for some reason dancing makes me happy, and then at the same time, I can stop and get, like, really self-image conscious, and I was doing, like, these hip-hop, like, one arm, flips or whatever. And I was just thinking about how fat I must have been looking like then, and I was like, I I did not do trigger warning. I did not do very good food-wise today. I ended up... Sorry, that's what I was at my door. I ended up, like, binging on Rice Krispies. And, then I ate, like, literally the only things that I ate today were... What's the count? Were three bowls of Rice Krispies. Graham crackers with frosting. And carrots and a cheese stick, and that's it. That's all I had today. And Fruit Loops, but I'll get back to that. I'm sorry. This is getting really long. Actually, it's not. I thought it would be much longer, but evidently I'm talking fast because I'm anxious and nervous, and yeah. So, I. Around 5 or 6 o'clock, it was 4, it was around dinner time, and I was hungry, but I didn't want to eat, but everyone else was eating, like, everyone else was having, like, an afternoon snack, so I decided to have Fruit Loops. I had two bowls of Fruit Loops, and then afterwards I felt so terrible about myself. I had a full can of Sprite Zero and, like, literally went and did, like, full body, like, shakes to mix everything up. I know, guys, I'm really sorry. I told you trigger warning. And I ended up going and purging everything. And I felt really bad and really ashamed because I was doing so good. I mean, like, mental wise, not actual behavior wise, but I was doing really good body image wise for the rest of the day. And it just put me in a really bad place. But I decided that I was going to have ravioli for dinner. So I did that. I didn't finish it, but I at least made an effort. And then I just had about 1/8 of a cup of, like, sunflower seeds for protein, because I don't really have any protein except for the cheese and the ravioli. So that's that. I don't know, guys. I told her yesterday, I said, I'm at the point right now. She said, she told me, she's like, this is something that doctors don't tell you, and no one's going to tell you it with people who have recovered. And she said, you're at the point now where you have to decide if you want to be done with this, if you want to be over this, if you want to get help, you need to decide that now, because right now it's up to you. She's like, it is eating disorder, it is an eating disorder, it's your brain, it's, you know, all of the psychological stuff with it, but right now it's also, you do have a choice where you can not stop it, but you can make the conscious decision to get help to stop it. And that's where I told her, I'm like, I'm at the point where I want to stop it. I want to have the desire to stop it, and I don't. And I want that really bad because I want to get better. But I know that the notes doesn't work. I know that talk therapy doesn't work. I know that group therapy doesn't work just by itself. Because I've tried all these things, I know that going to meetings don't help. I've learned, obviously, that what I'm doing right now isn't helping. So I'm at the point right now where it's either TK or nothing. Because I'm not doing when it melts again. I'm not going through that again. It didn't help. I made some really great friends there. I enjoyed the social aspect of it, but the actual therapy didn't help for me. I just didn't appreciate it. I mean, I had a therapist that didn't do anything for me. There was a therapist there that wasn't my therapist, but she was also sort of a pain clinic person, so I talked to her a lot. But I mean, if I had her, I think I would have had a better experience. But I mean, the therapist that I had decided to go on vacation the week that I was supposed to be discharged without telling us ahead of time, and stuck us with a random psychologist, or a random therapist that I didn't know and wasn't comfortable talking to. So basically I left with a very huge deficit in where I should have had more therapy. So it kind of sucked. But I definitely recommend if anyone's in the Illinois area, or if anyone's in Illinois and looking in the Naperville area to do therapy, I highly recommend the program. It just wasn't for me. And definitely not the self-harm aspect of the One and Only program. The eating disorder EDP program was amazing. It didn't work for me, but it was amazing. And then with the self-harm, the St. Charles unit, just, I've been there twice now. Yeah, twice. Did not work. So I don't know. And it sucks because at Linden Oaks, you either have the option of self-harm treatment in one place, or eating disorder treatment in another place. And right now, I need a combination of both. And I know that some of the therapies transfer, but it just wasn't. I needed both. And the only place that has both in my area is TK. So I touched on that in the other blog that I have. I may be getting new insurance that may be covering TK that I may be utilizing in the near future, maybe, possibly, I don't know, probably not, but maybe. So yeah, this is very therapeutic. I really appreciate you guys letting me get all my thoughts out there. I'm sorry this is so random and so late. If anyone's watching this, I doubt anyone is, because no one seems to be interested in my life, which I don't blame you, because I'm not interested in it either. Yeah. So, wish me luck, internet. I'm getting my nerves cauterized. It's called radio frequency lesionizing or something. I don't know. And I'm sick still. So the purging did not help that. Okay, thanks guys. I appreciate it. Again, thank you. So yeah. Thanks. Bye.